Is it too late to buy? Should I wait for the correction? Is there a crash around the corner? It's definitely too late. All of these companies are all overvalued. If you want to know the best time to invest your money, watch this video. Now, the answer is now. The answer is so simple, but our emotions make it so difficult to invest our money wisely. We always want to make the right decision to not lose our hard-earned money. But in reality, the fear of making mistakes will cost you even more. Here are just a few examples. Tesla was trading around $700 only a month ago. A lot of people said it's overvalued and they want to wait for a correction to buy in cheaper. On July 18th, Bitcoin was trading at $29,000 and tons of people were saying that it will drop even lower and they will just wait for that to happen and then they will buy in. Around 3 months ago, Netflix was trading around $500 and you guessed it, people were saying it's overvalued. It is a big mental challenge to invest into an asset that's currently trading at an all-time high because we believe that this is the highest it will ever go. I mean, it's called the all-time high and it's happening right now. The risk of investing into an asset and this asset losing 20 to 30% within a couple of months is given at any moment. But at the same time, you also have the chance of that specific asset gaining 20 or 30% within the same time frame. Before investing, you need to understand that you will never be able to time the market perfectly. And I have a beautiful example for this. I tried to outsmart the market when I did my $10,000 day trading challenge. And here are the results. I started with $10,000 and I said, I'm gonna day trade cryptocurrency on a daily basis to see how far I can go. I was able to trade that $10,000 into a $50,000 portfolio, which sounds amazing, right? Not so much. The first trade I ever did allowed me to purchase 400 BNB, which at that time was valued at $10,000. If I just held those 400 BNB, today I would sit on $262,000. That's a discrepancy of $212,000. So by me trying to be smarter than everybody else, I lost out on $212,000. So what's the best thing to do? Start investing today. Either dollar cost average into your favorite asset, or if you have a lump sum, put it in right away. Dollar cost averaging. If you don't have a lump sum ready to invest and you just use a percentage of your paycheck to just invest into an asset, dollar cost averaging is what you have to do. It's a beautiful strategy because you benefit from both the up and down trends. If you start investing today and within the next week it goes up in value, all the shares that you purchased are now valued more. The downside is that now with the same money, you can buy less shares. On the other hand, if you bought today and next week it decreased in value, obviously your portfolio is worth less, but also now you can purchase more shares for the same money. So by dollar cost averaging into an asset, you basically buy weekly, monthly, whatever you decide on a regular basis all the time. You don't care what the price looks like right now. You buy in when it's high, you buy in when it's low, and then it averages out your price. Lump sum. If you have a lump sum ready to invest, I personally always tend to put in the entire amount immediately. I don't like to use my lump sum and divide it by a couple of months and then just, you know, basically dollar cost average into an asset, because if I have the money ready, I want to put it in there because then I have the upside potential, but also the downside risk. Why do I prefer that over dollar cost averaging? It's because my investment strategy is long term. When I say long term, I'm talking 10, 15 years. And I believe that in 15 years, it doesn't really matter if I bought in at 300 or at 280. So I don't see myself touching my investment portfolio within the next 10 years. I just want to accumulate more and more and more and just build a big enough portfolio so in 10 years, I can just borrow against it. Therefore, for me right now, it's more interesting to just put the money in right away, because then not only can I use, you know, options trading for an additional income, but at the same time, I have all that upside potential of like a massive growth within a company that I invest in. A good example of this lump sum investment was my Bitcoin investment. I purchased $160,000 of Bitcoin when Bitcoin was trading around $48,000. Of course, now looking back, if I had waited a little bit longer, to be exact 3 weeks, I could have bought in a lot more because it dropped to $30,000. But that's something we already talked about. You will never be able to time the market perfectly. Neither can you predict the future. So So if you're ready and you want to invest in stocks and cryptocurrency, don't wait and don't listen to news outlets telling you that a new correction of a bear market is around the corner. If you're sitting on the sideline with your money waiting to be invested, I promise you, you will miss out on a lot of money. Obviously, with any asset, you have to do your own research and figure out if the asset, the company, the cryptocurrency is worthwhile and it's going to be around for the next 10 years, because not every single company or cryptocurrency will be around within the next 10, 15 years. And as soon as you start investing into the stock market or cryptocurrency, I promise you, over the lifetime of your trading journey, you will encounter some, hopefully not that many, but you will encounter some corrections, which is absolutely normal. And don't try to time the market, because you have to be right twice. First of all, you need to figure out when the all-time high is so you can sell at the right time. If you manage to do that, the next step is you need to figure out when it bottoms out to buy back in again. And on top of that, for that difference, you have to pay taxes. So if your goal is to invest rather than trade, start today, pick your favorite asset, put $100, $200, whatever you can afford, put that aside and dollar cost average into that asset. If you have a lump sum ready, put that into an asset that you believe will be around for the next 10 years and you're good to go. If you haven't started yet, the most important thing for you is to get started, to build a big portfolio. You will never figure out the best timing. Honestly, the best timing is now. Start building your portfolio today. I promise you, your future you will thank you later.